Hi guys, this is Eric. The project to be shared in this video is a brute force USB keyboard using USB HID. Many things are possible because the OS systems recognize it as a regular USB keyboard. For example, it's possible to have a specific key pressed when a hardware button is pressed. A brute force attack is a method for breaking an encryption by trying all possible encryption key. Systems these days have a lot of preparations for these attacks. For example, if the password is wrong several times or more in a row, you may have to wait more than 30 seconds. If you keep getting it wrong, sometimes the system locks up. In this case, it will be better to find an attack exploit rather than the brute force attack. Conversely, there are still many systems that are vulnerable to brute force attacks. The parts of old systems and BIOS are still possible. What I'm showing you right now is the login screen of macOS. Added a reader feature so that it can keep entering even if the password is wrong. In general, if the password continues to be incorrect, a pop-up appears and keyboard input is no longer possible. But for now, it can still enter a password. To perform a brute force attack properly, you must find and understand how the target system works and prepare your own tools in response. Also, the problem with this attack method is that it takes a lot of time because password keys are substituted one by one. Finally, the password I put in advance came out and successfully logged in. Let's see how the system is configured. It's based on ESP32S2 because it used the native USB interface. If necessary, please refer to the previous video about using native USB of ESP32S2. It's necessary to prepare the password set first. I put it on its internal file system. It would be better to use a SD card. I'll update when I get a chance. Anyway, the main program reads one by one from this password set, prints it on the screen, and also prints it through a USB HID keyboard. It's a simple system. This is a project I'm gonna share with you. The download link can be found in the video description below. It contains only the most base part, and based on this, you need to find and put rules to attack the target system. I used Raviang GFX to drive the ST7789 display included with the ESP32S2. If you don't need the display part, please remove the display class. I used SPI FFS as a file system. Little FS is faster and more reliable, but FileIO is not very important for this project. You can use the FileIO you want. Next is the password set. If you Google it, you can find many password sets. It's recommended to prepare a password set that meets the password rule required by the target system. Create a data folder in the project folder and put the password text file in it. Upload the file to the ESP32S2 using the ESP32 Sketch Data Upload tool. The file was successfully saved. This is the most important part, I think. You will need to modify this part for your target system. First, you need to decide how many seconds you want the password to be entered. Also, if the entered password is incorrect, most pop-ups appear, so the enter key must be entered at least once. It takes a lot of effort to get a good grasp of the target system. In this code, the password is simply entered every 1 second. I will unload it and show you how it works. USB UART is no longer needed, so remove it. Native USB port is connected, turn on the switch. Power is on, it reads the file and shows how many passwords there are. In fact, this is a very, very small data set. Some passwords are a few hundred megabytes. Input starts after 3 seconds count. Passwords are read and entered one by one in Excel according to the rules I made. Also, the enter key works properly, so it's making empty spaces one by one. This is my first project with ESP32S2. It seems more useful to create and use a macro keyboard rather than a brute force attack. Anyway, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you in the next project.